Bloomberg Senior West Coast correspondent John Ehrlichman is there. He's live with us right now from Cupertino, California. It's very early there, John.
4 a.m.
Excitement has to be building already. Thanks for joining us, John, this early. You know, with all of your great reporting from Bloomberg West, all of the leaks and the speculation, what exactly do we know about what is set to be released today?
Sarah, this is a very iPhone-focused day. If you're thinking about wristwatches or TVs or Apple's next big thing, this is probably not the event for it. But does that really matter when the iPhone is such an important product for this company? Just to reiterate what we are expecting not one, but two iPhones to be announced today. One, basically, the next version of the iPhone 5, maybe a couple of new bells and whistles, maybe a fingerprint sensor. But then, more importantly, the fact that they are expected to unveil a lower-price new iPhone, something they have never done before and has raised a lot of questions about whether or not Apple is shifting its strategy, what does this mean for the brand. But in the same breath, there are just as many people who say Apple should have done this a long time ago because the market dynamics are changing quickly in places like China, and Apple is facing a lot of competition from the likes of Samsung.
John, of course, this is all hardware that we're talking about. Any word on iOS 7, which is important because that helps push people to upgrade their phones as well?
Yeah, I mean, Apple already gave us a taste of what that new software would look like. And you raise a good point, Scarlett. I mean, if we know that the software change is going to be dramatic enough that when you use your phone, it's going to be a different experience, maybe they don't have to offer as many new bells and whistles to get people buying new iPhones. We don't know. But in the next couple of weeks,
right,
no doubt they'll be rolling out that new software.
John, the high in Cupertino this afternoon is 97 degrees. What is making Tim Cook sweat? He's not Steve Jobs. He's got to go out there and do the dog and pony for the true believers. What is making Tim Cook sweat this morning?
Well, I think, you know, when we think of Steve Jobs versus Tim Cook, yes, Steve Jobs, product innovator, no one can deny that. But he, too, was a businessman, and he, too, would have seen the opportunity and saw the opportunity in a market like China, a market that Tim Cook has visited many times in the last couple of years. He talks about those numbers on the earnings calls all the time. It's a company that generated something like $4.9 billion in revenue last quarter from Greater China. I think the challenge that Tim Cook faces when he isn't necessarily the ultimate product man. Sometimes he shares the stage at events like this with the rest of the folks here at Apple at a time when there are a lot of rapidly growing companies in China that are creating their own fan bases around their companies. I think that's probably the biggest challenge, is to make sure that the
right
Chinese consumer, along with consumers everywhere, are getting on board with the Apple story.